sky. All right, welcome back. Now, you've seen Israelis celebrating the move of the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem, while Palestinians are engaged in deadly protests.
Join us now to discuss the fallout of all this is Rabbi Chaim Metz of the Chabad of Bel Air. Thank you so much for being here. Good morning to you.
Good morning. So, what do you think of all this?
Well, there's a lot of tragedies out there. There's unfortunately people that are being killed because of people being sent to the front lines to go and just go and fulfill whatever Hamas wants them to do. So I feel bad that there's a lot of people that are being killed. But then on the same token, you got to think about it. The world is calling it a protest. Well, I've seen a lot of unions outside protesting with signs. I never see them breaking windows. I never see them going into this station and saying, "We want to murder you." So when you have 50,000 people that are trying to invade a border, you got to defend yourself like any other country. Unfortunately, there are babies there. Mm-hmm. I mean, who puts up babies? Babies. Mm-hmm. I mean, if this was happening in America, we would be calling the family, you know, the centers and saying, take away the babies from these mothers. What mother takes a baby to go and be shot at? But this is human shields, and the world is calling this a protest. No, it's an invasion.
Well, some of those people would say that they're hopeless, that there's a lot of poverty, that they're not being taken care of by the world community, that Israel's ignoring their concerns, and the Trump administration is being deliberately provocative by doing this.
You know, those are fantastic questions. The world goes and says that they're living in poverty. Okay, so we gave them Gaza. Here, guys, take Gaza. The part that Israel gave of Gaza looked like Fort Lauderdale. There was a huge, beautiful place growing. Did you know 11% of tulips used to come, of the world's tulips, came what the Israelis gave back? They voted in Hamas. We give them billions of dollars. Where's the money going to?
So you think they're ruining their own state?
No. Their leaders are using them as pawns. I'm not thinking. These are facts. Mm-hmm. These are facts. Did you ever go on a YouTube and Google what the life is like in Gaza with all the beautiful malls that they have? Do you know they have beautiful shopping malls in Gaza? But no, we only look what the narrative tells us.
In the last hour, we had Deputy White House Press Secretary Raj Shah on talking about this situation. Let's listen to what he had to say and get your reaction.
All right.
Rather, the president's decision is courageous. It's the right decision. It's a recognition of reality. There's a reason why previous presidents have pledged to move the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem. It's because the action makes sense. It is actually Israel's capital, and we've been walking on eggshells as a matter of U.S. diplomacy for decades. This was the right move, and it makes sense.
Your reaction?
Of course it makes sense. Mm-hmm. For 3,000 years, this has been our capital. So all of a sudden, could you imagine London goes and says, I mean, England says, we want London to be our capital. And someone says, no. And all of a sudden, United States says, we want Washington, D.C. to say, America says, we want Washington, D.C. to be the capital. No, Israel, we want Jerusalem to be capital because that's where King David started all. No, you can't. Hello.
But Palestinians have said that Jerusalem is their capital. That's the holiest site that they have.
Great.
And that there could potentially be a two-state solution.
I'm going to say something very controversial to you. Before Yasser Arafat declared that we are a movement called the Palestinian Liberation Organization in 1964, what Palestinian people were there? Where? Did you ever hear a language Palestinian? Did you see a coin? Do you see any history of it? So if we keep on perpetuating it, so they would love to have Palestinians, would love to go and say Jerusalem is theirs. 1 minute. You were given 50% of it under the Prime Minister Al-Murt. You were given 50%. Yasser Arafat said, no, we want the whole thing.
Okay.
So what do the Palestinians want?
Well, here's the thing. I think a lot of people want peace.
I do too.
Okay, so you want peace.
We all do.
Netanyahu said he wanted peace. The White House says they want peace. But when something like this happens, and there's a reason why past presidents have not done this and made this move, is because they want peace versus this definitive kind of move to signal, you know, throw a line in the sand. So how can we achieve peace?
Right. I mean, does this help the negotiations?
Yes.
That's a great question. Do you know what the Palestinians have always said? They've always said, we will give us all this land on the West Bank and give us Gaza, and then we'll talk about Jerusalem. And then on the last day, after they get this and get this and get this, then they're going to say, no, the whole Jerusalem is ours. Donald Trump went and said like this, you know, Israel deserves to say that their capital is Jerusalem. It's been like that from King David. Get that off the table. Can we talk about the West Bank now in Gaza that you've already have? Are you willing to talk about it? No. But you said that's the end game. I do believe that Donald Trump at the end of the day may go and say, Palestinians, we'll give you East Jerusalem as a capital. Mm-hmm. But don't argue mm-hmm. what the Jews are allowed to have. They've been here for 3,000 years. Mm. So what he really did was he took the flames of fire that the Palestinians are always saying, no, give us everything, and then we'll talk. And they can walk away and say, we're not giving you anything.
Yeah. Well, clearly this is such a passionate issue for so many people, and clearly there are a lot of different views out there. We thank you for sharing yours.
Thank you.
Rabbi, thank you for allowing me to be here.
My pleasure. All right.